You know, as Catholics, we are so familiar with the image of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. But I just wanted to speak a moment about how the Church received this devotion in honor of the Sacred Heart of Jesus Christ. Where did it all begin? Well, probably the best place to begin thinking about devotion to the Sacred Heart of Jesus is back in the 17th century with a very pious nun named St. Margaret Mary Alacoque. And Margaret Mary related to us, to the Church, that one day while she was in her convent chapel and she was praying before Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, that something extraordinary took place in her prayer life. Suddenly, Jesus manifested himself from the tabernacle. And so Margaret Mary could see Jesus with her eyes. And Jesus said this, "Margaret, I want you to look upon my Sacred Heart, this heart that has loved mankind so much, and all that this heart receives in return is negligence and forgetfulness." Really, the Sacred Heart devotion is an appeal from God for the love of his creatures. Jesus is begging for his love to be returned. And so that's where really the beginning of the Sacred Heart devotion takes off in the Church. And you know, when children, when they see the image of the Sacred Heart, you know, for the first time, they often ask, "Well, what are all those things on the heart of Jesus?" Well, when he did expose his heart to St. Margaret Mary, there were some symbols on his heart. And so the first thing that we see on the Sacred Heart of Jesus is the fire, the flame of love that is symbolic that the heart of Jesus Christ is on fire with the very love of God the Holy Spirit, in love for his Father and for every single member of the human race. What's interesting with this image is that we are reminded that God now loves us with a human heart. The Word made flesh, God the Son, now loves us with a human heart. And remember, when we say heart, coming from the Sacred Scriptures, the human heart stands for the entire person, for his interior life. So that's the heart of Jesus on love for God, in love for God the Father, and on behalf of all humanity. We see on his heart a crown of thorns. A young child would say, "Well, I thought Jesus wore the crown of thorns on his head. Why is it on his heart?" Because it is a reminder that our sinfulness not only caused pain to his body in the sacrifice of the cross, but also caused him interior suffering. Remember the interior suffering, the emotional, the psychological suffering that Jesus endured in his agony in the garden on Holy Thursday. So his suffering is not just physical, but also mental, emotional, and psychological. He felt our sinfulness in his heart. And then we see surmounted on the heart a little cross. Well, why does he have the cross in his heart? It's a reminder that he bore the cross in his heart long before he bore the cross on his shoulder on Good Friday, the sufferings that came along with becoming man. And then finally, we see the wound in his heart that was placed there after he expired on the cross. The wound in his heart that still remains there is a reminder that Jesus poured himself out completely on behalf of our salvation to the last drop of his precious blood. And also the wound on the heart of Jesus is an invitation to take refuge in his heart, to enter into his heart. He has given himself completely and he wants to enter in. And you know, oftentimes when we think of the Sacred Heart devotion, we think of the 12 promises that Jesus made to St. Margaret Mary For those who are devoted to his Sacred Heart, we often think of the promise he made for those who make the first Fridays of reparation, those who receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament on first consecutive Fridays of the month, that he would promise them that those people, when they pass away, they would not die without the sacraments of the Church. So that's a great promise, the 9 first Fridays. Also, he made a promise that he would bless those homes where an image of his Sacred Heart is exposed and honored within the family, within a religious convent, within a church, that he would bless that family. But also, there's something else that we often don't hear about, but Jesus also requested that an image of his Sacred Heart be worn. He told Margaret Mary Alacoque that he would like her to wear an image of his Sacred Heart, and that he would bless those who wear an image of his heart. And so St. Margaret Mary, she began to get to work right away, and she made her novices wear the image or the badge of the Sacred Heart, and she made many badges of the Sacred Heart to be distributed to people, and people realized that blessings were flowing upon those who wore an image of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. And so you can still purchase one of these Sacred Heart badges in any religious goods store. On the badge of the Sacred Heart, it says around the heart, "Sacred Heart of Jesus, thy kingdom come." And it says, "Cease, the heart of Jesus is with me." In other words, be quiet. The heart of Jesus is with me. Be quiet to the temptations that are assailing me. Be quiet to the anxiety, the discouragement, the noise of the world. Cease. The heart of Jesus is with me. Or cease. I'm living in the peace of the heart of Jesus Christ. So you might want to think about getting one of these badges in honor of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Put it in your wallet or wear it next to your heart as a constant reminder that you are a child of God, beloved of Jesus Christ. And also on this Friday, the Feast of the Sacred Heart, you might consider consecrating yourself and your family to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. God bless you. Oh, say.